Both groups, Westboro Baptist Church and other Calvinists, believe a major important doctrine is the sovereignty of God. In other words, they don't believe there's any free will because free will would contradict the sovereign God, as they put it. They believe God commands everything that happens, and he is in ultimate control because he set it into motion. Therefore, no free will exists because God decided it before it began. A corollary of this is how God uses evil people. This is why Westboro Baptist Church has signs such as God sent the shooter and thank God for 9/11. They claim that God even used Osama bin Laden. Pretty outrageous, you would think. But actually, I've been listening to this sermon by Trevor Hammock, and he was saying how he believes God uses people. Like, he mentioned Malachi and this thing that happened in the Old Testament where God used lying false prophets. And Westboro Baptist Church says that too. Again, I'd like to reiterate the point that Trevor Hammock and Westboro Baptist Church are extremely different. Westboro Baptist Church is full of hate, and Trevor Hammock is not full of hate. But there is some commonality of Calvinist doctrine. Additionally, I've found one similarity that is a lesser extent. It's not strong doctrine, but it is practice. The third generation of Westboro Baptist Church, with all their females in there, generally don't date. Some have married, such as Benjamin Phelps, but the women just aren't dating. They believe it's wrong, there's no one right to date. But, of course, the second generation, there are some people who dated and married. This is partially based in Calvinism. For example, Joshua Harris, who is known for the book I Kissed Dating Goodbye, has some strong views on dating. He believes dating in its current form is an abomination. In one letter on their webpage of Spare Not blogs of Westboro Baptist Church, they address the issue of dating, and they believe it's in its form today, it's wrong. Now, obviously, Joshua Harris isn't picketing people's funerals or scolding homosexuals for their sins. But he is stressing that message that dating in its current form is an abomination, just like Westboro Baptist Church does.